Hello everyone, this is Pastor Apostolos. Welcome to Grace and Truth Church Online. It's so wonderful to have you here today, and I'd just like to let you know that wherever you may be or whatever situation you may be in, you are constantly in our thoughts and prayers. Today we have the great pleasure of having Dr. Enoch bring God's word to us today. What does our life depend on? What is the key to having a fulfilling and fruitful life? What did Jesus mean when he said, "Man does not live by bread alone, but on the word of God"? Well, that is what Dr. Enoch, my dad, will be speaking to us about today. But before that, let us prepare our hearts for God's word by singing some worship songs and having a time of prayer.
You were the word at the beginning, one with God the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, our cry. What a beautiful name it is, what a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is, nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without. What a powerful name it is. without light. Till from heaven you came running, there was mercy in your eyes. To fulfill the law and prophets, to a virgin came the word. From a throne of endless glory to a cradle in the dirt. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King.
Created all things and sustain all things with your word. Today we say, as King David does in Psalm chapter 119, verses 89-93. Your word, Lord, is eternal. It stands firm in the heavens. Your faithfulness continues through all generations. You establish the earth and it endures. Your laws endure to this day, for all things serve you. If your law had not been my delight, I would have perished in my affliction. I will never forget your precepts, for by them you have preserved my life. Yes, Heavenly Father, Lord, we praise you, for you are the bread of life. We live not by bread alone, but by your word. Help us, O Lord, to rely on your word rather than the things of this world. May your word dwell richly in our hearts, for that is where our life comes from. May we love your words and meditate upon them all day long, for blessed are those who keep your statutes. Help us, O Lord, to put your words into practice, that we may be like trees planted by streams of water, bearing fruit in every season. Help us, O Lord, during these turbulent times of ours, to find reassurance and hope and strength in your words. We pray, Lord, for those who are affected by the floods right now, that you will bring comfort to them and help them to rebuild their lives. We pray, Father, Lord, for the people of Ukraine, that you will bring peace to the region and bring an end to the violence. Father, Lord, we pray for your kingdom to come. For it is only when your kingdom comes that there will be a final end to all the evil and injustice and suffering and brokenness of this world. Father, may you draw near to the people of Ukraine, and may they find hope in the good news of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, we lift up to you GTC. May you build this church to become a strong and healthy church that brings the good news of Jesus Christ to the ends of the world. We pray particularly, Lord, for the upcoming auction for a property that our church is looking to purchase. Father, Lord, may you guide our church to make the right decision. And we pray, O Lord, that if this is the place you have prepared for us, that you will secure it for us and provide us with the finances and the resources, Lord, to get it. And give us faith, O Lord God, the faith to move mountains. Father, Lord, we pray for my dad, Dr. Enoch, today, that you will empower him with the power of the Holy Spirit, so that as he delivers your word, Lord, your word will convict our hearts and take root in us and change us, Lord. So, Lord, we commit the rest of today's service to you, Lord. May your word dwell richly among us and bear fruit in our lives. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
What's life all about? Why are you here? Where are you going? These are all the questions that Pastor Apostles asked 2 weeks ago in his sermon. And on this note, I wish you all Shabbat Shalom in Emmanuel, rest and peace in the presence of the Lord. 5 weeks ago, in my sermon for the Chinese New Year, I preached on appetite, spiritual appetite. And in the sermon, I quoted the statement of the Lord, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word from the mouth of the Lord. And after the sermon, this verse kept on echoing inside me. And I knew That was the verse and that was the title for my next sermon. And for this verse and this title, I'm here today. Man like to measure the meaning and the value of another person's life in terms of in a material way. They may look at how much the person can earn, what kind of respectful career the person is, all this kind of material ways. If life can be measured in such a material way, I'm sure that all the questions that's asked in past apostles' sermon on what's life all about will not bother so many people. This is why the Lord say that the man does not live on bread alone. But unfortunately, mankind keep on questioning this statement of the Lord. And some would say, look at these people. How can the law say man does not live on bread? Of course, bread here is referring to all the material things required to sustain physical life. And today, we use money, the word money, to summarize all the material requirement in life. Well, but the Lord did not say man does not live on bread, but the Lord said man does not live on bread alone. Well, if you think about all those people suffering from various kind of mental illnesses, such as depression, anxiety, eating disorder, psychotic illnesses, perhaps you may change your value of money before, or your value for money before. Yes? Do you agree with the Lord's statement? Man does not live on bread alone? If you don't, is there anything that you are not satisfied with in your life? Or you like to have more to make you happy and fully satisfied? You like more money? And you believe that having more money, you can buy this and that, have this and that, and your life will be happy? Then how about so many people who are well off in this world and their life are not happy? You like to have a life spouse or partner to live with so that you're no longer lonely and be happy? But do you know that the rate of devotion today is keep on rising, soaring, and every day, you know, there's a high rate of relationship breakups? Well, you think you have some achievement, you'll be happy because you can hear people saying praises to you? Then what happened to those people who have top achievements and they are still not happy? Well, this is why the Lord says man does not live on bread alone, but on every word from the mouth of the Lord. Why? Because mankind is made of three faculties, not just the physical body, but also the mental faculty and also the spiritual faculty. Yes, the physical body can be satisfied by food to a certain extent. Our smell sense, our taste bud, our hearing sense to some extent when you hear the zizzling noise of the delicious food, or our stomach, the sense of fullness. But any more? Can food satisfy for the physical body? And how long can a meal of food satisfy us? Well, we come to the mental faculty, all right? Yes, our cognitive aspect can be satisfied by knowing more, by knowledge, by our curiosity being fulfilled, satisfied. And that's why Apostle Paul said, knowledge puffs. Yes, knowledge puffs a person. But unfortunately, our curiosity, our cognitive faculty can never be fully satisfied, because life and the universe is a mystery beyond the comprehension of man's cognitive power. Well, good emotion? Yes, we all love to enjoy the good emotion. And good emotion makes us feel good, high, isn't it? But good emotion doesn't stay long. It will go away as our life situation and circumstances change, right? Let's come to the spiritual faculty. Yes, man's spiritual aspect can only be satisfied by another spiritual being. If it's that evil spirit that the person meet, I don't think he'll be satisfied, but his whole person will be tormented, and to the point that he may suffer from mental illness, to the point of suicide. And that's what our church has experienced 2 months ago. A young chap at the age of 20 committed suicide because his mind met an evil mind, evil spirit. They keep on tormenting him. What a sad story, real story. Well, but when man's spirit meets the good spirit of God, that's the Holy Spirit, the whole picture is different, because mankind is created with a God-shaped void inside us. And this void can only be filled by the Spirit of God. That's why the Lord said, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that come out from the mouth of the Lord. Yes, the Israel people, their daily physical needs are met by manna falling from heaven. But the Israel people's spiritual daily need, or today our daily spiritual need, can only be met by every word that come out from the mouth of the Lord. If you wonder why God's word can be so satisfying for mankind's spirit, then I would invite you to recite Psalm 19 or Psalm 119. Well, Psalm 119 is a very long version, all right? And mind you, we need to understand the context behind this verse. Man does not live on bread alone, but on the every word from the mouth of the Lord, all right? It's from Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 3b, but the context is from chapter 5 to chapter 11, and which on the 10 commandments of the Lord and his stipulation, decrees, and the laws, all right? And that's exactly what Psalm 19 and 119 is about. Let's recite it together.
Psalm 19, verses 7 to 11. The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The statutes of the Lord are trustworthy, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, giving joy to the heart. The commands of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The decrees of the Lord are firm, and all of them are righteous. They are more precious than gold, than much pure gold. They are sweeter than honey from the honeycomb. By them your servant is warned. In keeping them, there is great reward.
Well, from this psalm, I hope you will understand why God's word can be so satisfying. Because God's word is God's spirit. And God's word is also God's truth of life. And God's spirit will guide us how to cruise our earthly journey towards a heavenly home. And God's spirit will remind us of our relationship with the Lord. All right. And how to enjoy, you know, all the blessings, Shabbat Shalom, in the Lord. His love, the peace, and the joy. And that's why God's spirit, God's word is so satisfying. Well, I'd like you to imagine, for young lovers, all right? They can think about their beloved ones, even in their physical absence, when they're in love, right? The same thing for people, whoever they live or meditate on every word from the mouth of the Lord, even though they cannot see the Lord physically, but inside they can feel the presence, the Emmanuel of the Lord, and can feel His love, the joy, and the peace. And it's for this reason that a million of years later, God the Son, our Lord Jesus, said this. He said, "I'm the bread of life." And then He said, "My flesh can be eaten, and My blood can be drunk." In here, Jesus is referring Himself to be the every word come out from the mouth of the Lord. And Jesus here inviting mankind, each one of us, you and me, you know, to welcome Him into our life, to accept Him, to assimilate Him and His words, right, into a natural part of our body. But the point is that, how keen are we? How much desire we are for this kind of relationship? And how often do we read God's word? It's only when we are after God's grace, God's blessing, or when our life is facing big crisis and we're desperate for God's delivery. Remember, God's word is God's spirit, and God's word is God's truth. And that's why our law is not only full of grace, but also full of truth as well. You see? If we are only after God's grace, but not His truth, well, I would like you to read John 6 and see what will happen. Let's look at John 6 together. On hearing it, the Apostle John is referring to, on hearing Jesus say that His flesh can be eaten and His blood can be drunk. And the crowd thought, gee, this is a crazy, crazy saying. How can we believe in such a crazy man? And the crowd start to depart from Him. And then Apostle John continued to write. Many of His disciples said, "This is a hard teaching. Who can accept it?" Aware that His disciples were grumbling about this, Jesus said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you see the Son of Man ascend to where He was before? The Spirit gives life. The flesh counts for nothing. The words that I've spoken to you, they are full of the Spirit and life. Yet there are some of you who do not believe." For Jesus had known from the beginning which of them do not believe and who would betray Him. He went on to say, "This is why I told you that no one can come to Me unless the Father has enabled them. From this time, many of his disciples turned back and no longer followed him. You do not want to leave too, do you? Jesus asked the 12. Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and to know that you are the Holy One of God. Then Jesus replied, Have I not chosen you, the 12? Yet one of you is a devil. He meant Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, who though one of the 12, was later to betray him. Dear brothers and sisters and friends, yes, God is full of grace and full of truth, not just the grace. God's every word is his spirit and his truth, on which should man live. We are all born with a God-shaped void inside us, and only God himself can fill the void. Not another beloved person, not more money you have in your bank, or another great achievement. Well, Jesus said, Does my word offend you? And likewise, I would say it, Man does not live on bread alone, but on every word from the mouth of the Lord. Does this statement offend you? What if you so believe in the promises, in the prophecy, as recorded in the book Revelation, that the Lord Jesus will come back again, and there's a new heaven and earth, and there's a final judgment? With this statement, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word from the mouth of the Lord, offend you? Yes, the flesh gives life. No, the spirit gives life, but the flesh comes to nothing. Doesn't Jesus' statement, this statement, open a window to Pastor Apostle's sermon on what's life all about? On this note, I'd like to share with you my current spiritual journey on trying to get a property for GTC. Well, in past 9 years, GTC had many attempts trying to get a property, but failed. But every attempt actually contributed to my current determination to get the property at Church Street Parramatta today. When Pastor Apostolos emailed me the property detail, I had absolutely no interest to start off, because I knew the core price was 1.8 to 2 million. So expensive. How can I afford it? And that I can imagine the time and the effort involved in converting this warehouse into a church. Oh, I really was put off. But anyway, I flew along and went to have a look. And after the first inspection, somehow I could see the great potential of this property, this warehouse, for GTC's future. And then my interest in it started to grow. Now I'm going to post my view on this property on the screen. As you're reading sharing my views, I continue with my spiritual journey. Well, last year we lost a beating, for a property, church property in Parramatta. And since then, one of our committee member, Charles, kept on saying to me, GTC does not have a future without a property of its own. When I look back, the past 9 years of GTC, you know, the high level of commitment that the committee members, that all the, you know, the people who really love GTC has put in, I could not help agreeing with what Charles said. GTC has no future without its own property. And then I started to, you know, ask about myself, what's the meaning of life? And in January, I think some of you knew that Pastor Apostolos was nearly drowned to death in his 10th year wedding anniversary with his beloved wife. And that did have an impact on me. And I really asked myself, what's the meaning, what's the purpose of life? And then 2 weeks ago, Pastor Apostolos preached on the topic, what's life all about? Really, really reinforced what I was going through at that time. And according to Rick Warren in his book, Purpose Driven Life, he said, all right, pleasing the Lord, pleasing God is the purpose of life. Now I have to say, for GTC in the past 9 years, we have been pleasing the Lord because we can see many souls, broken souls, suffering souls were transformed and believe in Christ. And then I keep on asking myself, how keen am I to see GTC prevail in pleasing the Lord? What are the good reasons that I do not want to go ahead with pursuing this property, warehouse property, apart from financial reason? If I'm the only one in a financial position that can afford to secure a bank loan for the property and to bear the interest for the loan. If I stop pursuing for it, would the Lord be pleased with me? Then I know that. Then I decided I'd like to continue pursuing the property and trust the whole matter in God's hand. And I started to choose to believe that. If I'm willing to step out in faith, all right, in humility, all right, and I have to choose to believe that God's Spirit will also move and mobilize the members of GTC who really take GTC as their spiritual home, that they are willing to also increase their money offering to meet, you know, the increased daily expenses once we move into the property. And I also have to believe that God will continue to preserve my health, particularly my eyesight, so that I can still earn enough income to pay for the interest of the whole loan for the property. Well, on this note, I'd like to end with Psalm 16. Let's look at it together.
Psalm 16. Keep me safe, my God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, you are my Lord. Apart from you, I have no good thing. I say of the holy people who are in the land, they are the noble ones in whom is all my delight. Those who run after other gods will suffer more and more. I will not pour out libations of blood to such gods or take up their names on my lips. Lord, you alone are my portion and my cup. You make my lot secure. The boundary lines have fallen for me in pleasant places. Surely I have a delightful inheritance. I will praise the Lord, who counsels me. Even at night, my heart instructs me. I keep my eyes always on the Lord. With him at my right hand, I will not be shaken. Therefore, my heart is glad, and my tongue rejoices. My body also will rest secure, because you will not abandon me to the realm of the dead, nor will you let your faithful one see decay. You make known to me the path of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand.
Well, I have to say, the Lord is a fair God, right? He's fair for each one of his children. Right? He will be fair in giving chances for each one of his children to exercise his faith in him and also to exercise his love for him and for his kingdom. And on the property that Jesus is going to pursue for, God is fair for also each member of GTC in terms of an opportunity to exercise their faith in doing their money offering and to exercise their love for God and for God's family. Whoever that God gives more in terms of financial income, the person can give more, you know, back into God's kingdom and God's family. Whoever that God gives less, of course, the person can only give little for God and for God's family. But it's not the amount, how much we can give to God's family that matters. It's our heart behind our offering, our heart of gratitude, and also our heart, our love heart for the Lord, and also our faith, believing in God's provision is sufficient for us. On this note, I have to say this. May every word from the mouth of the Lord through King David in this Psalm 16 will bring you life. And as you are meditating on this Psalm 16, you can experience the heavenly peace, the pure joy, and also the eternal life in his words. May God bless all of you through his word today. Amen.
A lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a heart forever is one. your side, and I will love you to the
official part of our service today. We hope that you've been nourished by God's word today. But there's more. From 10:30 to 11:30, our church will be meeting online via Zoom to have some fellowship together and to discuss today's message. And this is a great way for us to get to know one another more and to allow God's word to sink deeper into our hearts and to spur one another to apply it to our lives. So we really hope that you can join us online. The details are on the screen because we would love to get to know you better. Also, as my dad Enoch mentioned today, our church is planning to attend an auction for a warehouse on Thursday, the 17th of March, to see if we can purchase our own building for church use. As you can imagine, this is a significant financial investment. So our church is conducting a survey to assess whether we have the financial ability to make this purchase. The link for this survey can be found on our church website homepage. If you would like to support the growth of GTC, we ask that you prayerfully consider how much you can financially contribute by filling in this survey. This is an anonymous survey. How much you can contribute is not what's important here. What we would like to find out is what is the level of commitment among the church members to go ahead with this venture. So even if it's just a few dollars, please still fill in this survey. The deadline for this survey is the 10th of March. Also, something very exciting is that our church will resume physical church services at the Lions Club Hall on Sunday, the 27th of March. So make sure you put that down in your diary. That would be great because we haven't seen each other for such a long time. Until then, however, we will stay online. Also, a huge thank you to all those who have been faithfully supporting the ministry of GTC with your financial support. If you would like to do an offering today, the online giving details are all on our website. Well, that's it from me today. It was wonderful having you. And may God be with you today, tomorrow, and the following weeks. See you next Sunday.